any spirituality. Stupid deep. Stupid deep. I mean, I done soaked up so much game, man. Let me tell you, man, like, I can real life look at the type of feathers that another Indian or native wears, and I can see what level of spirituality they're on. I can even distinguish if they're even on the path, or they're just wearing it as a costume, or if they're wearing it, you know, something that was passed down from chief to chief to chief, right? There's a big difference, and a lot of people don't know, right? You know, like, for me, right, I know the path of the hawk. Now, when I say I know the path of the hawk, you know, many people don't get it. Many people don't believe in the transmigration of the spirit and the soul, right? So, if I say I know the path of the hawk, what I'm telling you is I know how to take rebirth as a hawk. See, when you wear the feathers of a particular bird, many people do it for many different reasons. Some do it to, you know, keep, you know, ward off negative energy. Some try to absorb the energy of, you know, that actual predator, raptor, bird, you know. See, what a lot of people don't realize is that when we do a lot of our wearing our feathers, and we imitate the birds dancing in ceremonies, many of us are preparing ourselves for another chiefly birth, for being that actual bird. And so for me, I know the path of the hawk because I've actually, while still living, transmigrated my subtle body into a hawk. I know what it's like to be inside the body of a hawk, to try to make a screeching sound, right? So, it's no play for me, right? Now, of course, all the feathers I wear, I'm not trying to be that bird, but when you know the path of a particular bird, it's very special. And, let's not forget, right? Notice I said hawk and not eagle, right? So, this is very important to note, because among the southeastern woodlands, we had no eagle tribes, right? No eagle tribes. Go ahead and name the eagle clan. Go. Right? So, you know, now, in modern times, due to, again, you know, amalgamation of other people, invasion, war miscegenation, and the uniting of families and cultures, now in some of the tribes, there is some eagle culture, even in the so-called Cherokee, right? And we know that name is a corruption of Charagewi, right? The Alleghenies. They have a whole eagle ritual, right? You know. And it's the Wohale Dihi, right? Dihi. Wohale Dihi, the eagle killer, right? And there's a whole ritual behind that. I'll make a whole video going in on that. But, you know, modern Cherokees now, they wear the eagle feathers. A lot of natives wear the eagle feathers. Us aboriginals, I'm not saying you can't wear the eagle feather if you don't want to, but I know traditionally we didn't wear that eagle feather, right? Because the eagle, as much as it is majestic it's a vile bird, right? So, you know, you know, and, you know, if you don't know, you better study on them. So, me personally, I would never wear the feathers of an eagle. You can look in powwows now and see all kind of natives throwing on all kind of feathers on, but I'm not finna mess with that eagle feather. I mess with a tawadi. I mess with a hawk feather, right? Because I know the path of a hawk. I'm going to stay within my spiritual rank. And I'm not finna dabble around and grab any, you know, feathers and just throw it on me just to look indigenous. No, this is a real spiritual path. It's nothing we play around with. But, you know, yeah, you know. And, yeah, don't play around with this, all right? Because, you know, you don't want to play around with the wrong ego, right? A wrong energy of any bird, and you don't want the vengeance of that getting on you. So that's another important thing, right? Just don't grab any feathers, put it on you. Understand the bird, the history, what it means to the tribe, especially if it was gifted to you. But on that note, Dee Dee Yoli, huh? Dungalane is gone.